Hey guys, it's Cranky here. Just got done rebuilding the transmission cooler lines on my first generation Escort here, my 88 and a half. So, I just kind of want to show off, I guess. You can't see a whole lot from down here. There's the one line off the cool side of the radiator. Just comes down. This comes down and loops over here, and it's actually the top line right here. A small piece of rubber hose, and then that just kind of bends up at a 45 and goes into the fitting on the transmission right there. So that's a little bit different configuration from what I had originally. This was the line that came off of there, and it wasn't too much different, but I changed it around so that, where is that? No, that's that one. I changed it around a little bit so I could get the line in there the way I wanted. That was a failed attempt. I used the polymer coated steel line for two reasons. A, it's more corrosion resistant than your regular steel line, and B, it's at least for me more readily available than a short piece of 5/16 copper nickel, which I couldn't get locally unless I waited and paid a shipping fee. So yeah, so I would have done it copper nickel if I could have gotten a piece, but I didn't want to buy an entire roll of it. This is my power steering pump. It's leaking like crazy. For those who don't know, this is not from the power steering pump. This is undercoating that I sprayed on. Fluid film, to be exact. So then the other one got a little more intricate bends to it. It goes up there and kind of goes over, and so it misses the radiator hose here. And it comes back this way a little bit, and then comes over. And we've got a short piece of rubber on that one too. And then that piece I made as well. I've got some green grease on there to help mitigate corrosion where the flaring tool bit into the coating and scraped it off. So that's basically it. And then I just used unions and little flare barbs because I couldn't find locally a hose barb with a flare fitting that was female threads. So I had to get the ones with male threads and use unions. Not 100% ideal, but it's a lot better than what was in here, which was this kind of cobbed up mess. This was what I didn't like the most, this compression fitting in there so close to the radiator. I'm not a fan of compression fittings. They always seem to fail. So yeah, don't use those if you don't have to. They're fine for a quick repair, but not something I want to keep on there for a long time. And then I had these also compression barbs that are made for fuel injection tube. And the problem with that is they're made for nylon and they're smaller than the inside diameter of the hose. So you gotta clamp the crap out of it and hope it doesn't come off. So, yep. So, in case you're wondering, I used this hydraulic flaring tool here. Obviously, I don't expect anybody who's watching this to have one of these, because they are very expensive. This one was more than $500. And yeah, I mean, if I didn't do this kind of stuff for my day-to-day job, I certainly wouldn't own one myself. But this has these adapters for push connect forming, and that's what this car uses on the transmission side, so it makes that little bulge like this, And I wire brush the coating off so it seals good on the O-ring. And so, I mean, with a regular flaring tool, you're not going to be able to make that piece at home. So if you're in a bind, what you can do is, they might have one up here that I can show you. We don't use these anymore, and for good reason. But they make these fuel injection lines here. And as you can see, they've got the ridge bead on them. And then you can, you know, cut this and flare it or whatever. And they're made for fuel, but as you can see, you know, this has been on the shelf for years, but it's rusty just sitting here on the shelf. And that's why we don't want to use those anymore. Because it's just crappy line and it's going to rust out again. But if you have no other option for that piece by your transmission, that's a way out. Most auto parts stores, and like here's one that's the right size, 5/16. So that's a part number if you're in a bind for an 18-inch piece of tubing with that ridge bead on it that'll slide right into your transmission fittings on these cars. And the other end is probably made to go on nylon or maybe rubber hose, I'm not sure. But regardless, you can always cut the end of it off and make it into whatever end you want with a regular brake flaring tool. But that piece will help you a lot if you need to make those ends by the transmission and you don't have access to a fancy hydraulic flaring tool like I've got there. Because, like I said, I don't expect you to have this $500 flaring tool in your set of tools at home. But you can buy a standard twist type for double flaring for not a lot of money, and then you'd be able to make these joints here, and then so it's just a matter of buying that fuel line to get that piece there if you're stuck. But anyway, just wanted to kind of show that to you guys. Any of you have transmission cooler line problems and you're looking for a solution that's going to last, that's what I recommend. Either this green polymer coated brake tubing or the copper nickel. Like I said, I prefer the copper nickel. It's a lot easier to work with. It flares more easily, it bends more easily, and it'll never rust out. It's just a matter of, it's expensive, and I didn't want to buy a whole roll of it, especially in the 5/16 size, because it's not a very common size, and I would probably never use the rest of it up. So that's why I bought 2 60-inch stick brake line sticks of this this polymer coated line, and I just secured it with cable ties there because I don't really have anything else better here to attach it with. I don't have any like brackets or anything, but that's actually on there pretty good, and it's far enough away from the catalytic converter that it's not going to get too hot. And I feel a lot better about this than these old lines here, especially with this piece here, because that is actually original rubber hose to the car. And I don't really trust 30 plus year old rubber in any situation. So that's that. And funny thing, that underhood light never worked since I owned the car. Just came on while I was working on it today for whatever reason, and it's working now. So that's odd, because I never did anything with it.